So guys, I just learned that drilling into the Earth can tell us about outer space. What is going on here? Hello, Earthlings. Lisette here for DNews. Scientists are drilling into the Earth. We all know the Earth is made up of three major layers, the core, the mantle, and crust, which is where we all live. The crust floats on the mantle, a super thick layer of mostly slow-moving rock. We've been trying to reach the mantle since the 1960s, but despite numerous expeditions, have still not dug past the crust. By all accounts, attempting to reach the mantle is dangerous and expensive. So why are we trying so hard to get down there? Because the mantle can tell us a lot about the history and formation of our planet in the universe. The mantle makes up about 84% of the Earth's volume and is incredibly hot, with temperatures that range from around 1,000 degrees Celsius close to the crust to about 4,000 degrees Celsius near the core. The weight of everything above it creates pressure that builds up tremendously the closer we get to the core. Now, the crust varies from 5 to 60 kilometers thick, with the thinnest layers found under the ocean. The farthest we've gotten was in the 1980s in Russia's cold Peninsula, where they dug for 20 years and managed a 12 kilometer deep hole, which was probably not even halfway to the mantle. This and many expeditions have failed because of technical difficulties like improper equipment and just plain bad luck in choosing spots to drill. But this doesn't mean scientists have given up. More recently, a team of scientists from the International Ocean Discovery Program drilled into the ocean crust and were able to retrieve rocks that showed signs of life. The rocks contained methane and hydrogen, which, as one of the researchers puts it, microbes can eat to grow and form new cells. This is huge. Similar rocks, gases, and conditions are found in other planets. So according to the researchers, these rock specimens can aid our search and understanding of how extraterrestrial life may exist in similar inhospitable conditions in the depths of the universe. But reaching the mantle doesn't just teach us about space, it also teaches us about Earth. The mantle's activity is largely responsible for the movement of tectonic plates, which scientists theorize influences volcanic activity, earthquakes, mountain ranges, and movement in the oceans. So understanding the mantle can help us better understand the Earth's current topography and its history, including how our continents shifted throughout the ages and are shifting today. If we can drill down to the mantle, researchers could have this type of information straight from the source, increasing its accuracy. Right now, we can only make inferences about the structure of the Earth based on how fast an earthquake's seismic waves travel through the planet and the routes they take, what we see on the crust, and the composition of rock samples. It wasn't too long ago that, by chance, a volcano ejected a diamond from the mantle that confirmed that there is an ocean's worth of water in the mantle's transition zone. Scientists learned this because it contained ringwoodite with a certain amount of water in it. Now, this tiny rock made a huge difference. And look, these rocks are great, but they're inconsistent. We don't know when the next mantle rock will be spewed out of which volcano, or if it'll be intact enough for scientists to derive meaningful conclusions. We got lucky with this diamond, but often these rocks are too damaged. Most have been belched out from volcanoes, ejected by tectonic plate crashes, or carried upward to the ocean floor. These treacherous and often erratic journeys leave scars on them and leave scientists with messy data. It's hard to know what characteristics were the result of the journey versus reflective of the mantle itself. So drilling down to the mantle could mean that we would finally be able to get pristine samples of the mantle, and even an entryway for further exploration. It could give us a clear look at the mantle's composition, how it's moving, and more accurate readings of its velocity, pressure, and temperature. In essence, what the Earth and possibly the universe is made of. But the drilling we most often hear of is tied to oil. To learn where oil comes from, check out this video over on Test Tube News.
Historically, we've gotten our oil from traditional drilling. But nowadays, almost half of those 8.8 million daily barrels are so-called tight oil that we get from hydrofracking. There's been a lot of debate about that for environmental reasons, but it's big business for a lot of states.
And if you have a burning science question you want an answer to, let us know in the comments below. Keep coming back here for more DNews throughout the week. Thanks, guys.